because that thing gives that money. So for the man to say something is going wrong, you don't want her progress. And because you don't want her progress, she can even walk away from the marriage because she feels you don't love me that much. That's why you would have allowed me to make this money anyhow. Some men cannot pause on the track they have taken in order to work on their marriages because they feel the path they are taking is giving them enough money. So if their wife says, "Honey, we better watch this," he said, you don't want my progress. And because of that, we're leaving my house. The love of money. Ask your neighbor, do you love money this much? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the next thing there, I'm jumping on this. There is another phrase there that says, ungrateful. Ungrateful. There was a man I spoke here that deep down in my heart, I felt terrible. Almost all of us here, we are as ungrateful as it can be. Amen.
Amen.
Everybody at one time or the other goes to God and says, "God, if you do this for me, I will serve you with all my heart, and that service will last for 1 week." And you know one thing? They come to a point they will say, maybe even if I didn't say that, this thing would have still happened. They never believed that it was the statement they made that made God to respond to them. "God, if you give me a son, I will only make sure that I show up in your presence." Hello?
Hi.
Their son, instead of them taking their son to register their son, even in the choir or in the children choir, they will register them with Fieras of Valencia. Is somebody hearing me? How many of you that have children here that your child is a Fiera or Fiera? Nobody. Eh? Is that my precious?
Oh no.
Okay. Amen.
Amen.
Because we are so ungrateful. When God gives us money, we turn back at God and tell God, "You know I have become very busy." A very legitimate answer to God. "God, this business is prospering. I need to give it time and work on it and build it." You know why? They are working on it outside the presence of God. "God, give me a child." And God blesses you with children. "God, you know it's not easy to take care of children here in Europe. My father and my mother are not here. Because of that, I need to take care of them." Why were you not in the Bible study? "My son went to play ball." Why were you not around in the prayer meeting? "My daughter went to play ball." "Pastor, I'm going to be late on Sunday because there is a match my son needs to play." Hello? Am I making sense? I am talking about a typical thing that happens in our society. All of a sudden, the very blessing, the very son, the very daughter that God gave have become the reason. "God, you know we need to take, Pastor, you know we need to take care of these children." You are not lying. You should. It's your responsibility. But the best thing you can do for your child is to bring your child to where your child will know God. And how do you think he or she will do that when you don't know him? One of the things that God said about Abraham, "For I know that Abraham will teach his children." You are never in church and you expect your son will just grow up and be a godly man. Where will he get it from? You always in the bar. Hello? You always were in the bar. Your daughter, your son, all of a sudden they will learn from you the love of God while you are in the bar. No, they will learn what is in the bottle. The content of the bottle. Amen. What did I say? They will learn what is in the bottle. Amen. Ungrateful to God. never return thanks to God to say, Lord, I appreciate what you did for me. Hannah said, God, give me a son that he may serve me. And the Bible says that Hannah, when the child was born, Hannah took the child to the presence of God and left the child there. And that child grew up and became a prophet that long has been like him. I'm grateful. I'm grateful. Some of us here, we are even sick. Very sick. Deep down we know we are sick. But that sickness, God is even the one that is keeping us alive. You know what for them? So far there is life in us, we rather spend time in our houses. Some people will tell you, ah, Pastor, I wasn't feeling too well on Sunday to show up in church. Did you go to the hospital? He said, no. Only for you to go to dedication reception and see the sister there. What are you doing? I just managed to show up here. I've been lying down at home. I just managed. Somebody understand me? And I wonder what God will say. Some of us, while we are sitting in church, all of a sudden you will just go, Pastor, I don't know how I'm feeling. Let me go home and lie down. And God will guide you. God will not hit you. You hit that ground, come down, and walk and go to your house and on TV and sit in your chair. And I see God just looking and he asked, Mother, is this one of the children that I have? Is this one of them? And Jesus will say, yes, this is one of them. Amen.
Amen.
And some of them that are spiritual, they will just put in him. You'll be watching him. These people, massive church. Amen.
Amen.
At least they will not ask him to stand up when he doesn't want to. They will not ask him to close his eyes when he doesn't want to. He will be watching them. Where he feels like he will go to the toilet and come out. And even between the not while he's watching, he's missing his suit. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says that 10 men must come to Jesus. And he asked them to go, show yourself to the priest. And while they were going, they were healed of their leprosy. And one turned back and came to him to say thank you. And Jesus said, wait. Where is the rest money? And the nine have abandoned. I'm sure they didn't even show themselves to the priest. They have gone their way. Who is Jesus? But one was mindful enough to go back and say, I acknowledge what you did for me. The Bible says one of the terrible things we're going to see in our time is that people are going to be ungrateful. Some of our women are pregnant right now. Only for God to guide them. 9 months of this pregnancy and they will deliver. Do you know where the big party will happen? It's going to be outside the church. Let us manage the church. If you meet by and buy they will call life band and the party hall. Cigarette and you go and everything will be going on. Amen. They give tithes to God of pleasure. Some men will drink, get drunk, and some women. That is from there, they will end up in another man's house. You know why? Because a sister has decided to appreciate God for what God has done. God gave him or her a child. And the party in the presence of God, they just manage it if it's water or free will color. Nobody. The cattle of malt and everything is at the party hall. Some brothers, some of the relatives will not even show up in church because they know the real event is at the party hall. Am I making sense? Have somebody have grateful at you. Amen.
Amen.
Birthdays. Some people cannot afford to say, God, I am buying one chair to appreciate you for having kept me alive. They will contribute, they will bring 15 euro, Pastor, take this one, let them do cake for us. At the end of the service, behind the pastor, every member of the church have been invited in their house, because that's where time is needed to be given. Is somebody understanding me? God, it gets high, they do. People came to their house and ran 200 euro and shake them and say, congrats. It was a wonderful birthday. See you next week. Oh, okay, sorry.
Church.
Amen.
Amen.
People can even call pastor, I'm having a problem with my boyfriend. Hello? And pastor will come and start making peace between the boyfriend and the girlfriend. What boyfriend, what happened? He won't arrive. Girlfriend, what happened? He won't arrive. And at the end of the day, pastor will say, you people shouldn't worry and bless them. And pastor will be. Amen.
Amen.
Hello. And if that pastor refused to come and settle this boyfriend and girlfriend, two of them will liars and leave the church. The pastor doesn't do anything. Because he didn't come to settle boyfriend and girlfriend. But listen, it is even the abomination of people. Because it has entered into the system. A girl will say, pastor, I don't know what is wrong with this my boyfriend. Jesus Christ. Oh, the baptismal man is my man. My man. My man. Those ones, they have stayed for a long time. So the man has been elevated from boyfriend to my man.
Light on fire.
Unholy.
Amen.
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 When is it going to stop? When is it going to stop? Last time we had a tabernacle at a redeemed day, non-denominational all night. Some people came. Everywhere was filled. As we were living, we saw some brothers that came to them. As they were saying today, they're powerful. The girlfriend is by the side. They are going home to go and bless the prayers. The girl was powerful. They will choose men. That man of God, he can preach. Everybody that has a problem here, God is smashing it today. They will hold hands together and shout amen under the prayer of agreement. Amen.
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 Tell your neighbor, unholy.
Unholy.
It is barbaric. There is nothing to equal it. You can boldly enter into a church right now. A choir master has a girlfriend, a choir master. It's official those days. I am not saying that those days that life was more righteous than now. But while you're doing it, you're hiding it because you know that when people find out that it's going, it's not going to be good. But officially, pastor can call the girlfriend and say, where is your man? The choir master has his own. The drummer has his own. The keyboardist has his own. In fact, he's got those choir. And to one of them said, the glory didn't come down in the church. Why should the glory come down? Come to where? Where do you want the glory to settle? Is somebody understanding me? Something is happening in that church. Why shouldn't things happen there? Pastor, you need to pray. Some people will even call you pastor after having woken up with their boyfriend and told me that they had a vision about the church. If what I have seen is only God that will have mercy on them. Some people will call me as I'm talking and hearing their boyfriend's voice from the background, and he's telling me, God, don't reveal something. That's somebody unholy.
Unholy.
And I am supposed to listen to the vision and the revelation. And he will now advise me, or she will, pastor, you need to call for prayer. Call for prayer. 2 days prayers. And if I am stupid enough to deny the prayer, she will come. And he will not come. I will come back and pray by myself. Because a girlfriend saw a vision for the church. Pastor, I saw snakes in the church. That's somebody unholy.
Unholy.
I know when I finish with that, as soon as some of us will leave there, don't forget. Ask your neighbor, are you Buddha?
Are you Buddha?
I had a friend those days, they call him Buddha guy. And if you see him in school those days, you will know why he was called that name. Amen.
Amen.
Buddha guy. People are helpless these days. You can give a brother all your savings, 5,000. Please keep this thing for me. Some you will give them for 1 year, maybe when you come back. There are brothers in church, you will just give them, hold this 5,000, let me collect this book, and I will meet you in your house. From there, getting to his house, he will start telling you stories. I mean, bros, it was the money I gave you in the afternoon, not the one of last year. You didn't ask, I was just coming. No man and money now. Because now, they just called me. My father, they are going to do him major pressure from here till his leg. You know, there are these things. You said, there is no way I was. But don't worry, I'm not saying I'm not going to, I will pay you. Sometimes, you will call somebody to come and help you because it's like the whole thing is not making sense. Brother, please, what I'm saying is, I gave him money by two. I came back by three to collect it. He will not call the person and say, I'm not saying he did not, he did. But something came up. But I will pay him, I will pay him. On your way out, he will give you 100, you just hold this one. Let me, there is something I'm working on. 2 years later, you people are still on it. Brutal. Amen.
Amen.
I traveled home when I went home. I came to a wedding and found out that the wedding was not maybe as it was supposed to be. I was asking because there were two brothers who were doing the wedding. And I was asking, what about the senior brother? They said that he didn't come. What happened? He said, you see this house? There was a mansion that this brother built. It was the picture of the mansion he sent to his brother that he had finished his house, his brother's house. Only for the man to come back, plan the wedding. His junior brother did his own invitation. When you see the invitation of the junior brother, you will clap for him. He did the invitation. The senior brother didn't know. And the man was running down. They told him they have done everything. Packed him in one car in front, not knowing that it was not his own. Packed in front, a snap picture and everything. Only for him to come back. His brother pointed at one empty grand for him. He said, but what about the money for the house? He said, no, that something happened and everything. But this was the house you showed me. He said, no, that maybe it was a mistake, that this one is his own. But don't worry, after wedding, I can give you one room into the house. Hello? And you can imagine, there was no guilt in his mind. He still went on with it. And when this other brother wanted to really behave badly, people asked him, are you the first person? I beg, go and sit down. Hello?
Hi.
Are you the best? You want to kill your brother because he ate your money? Some people, that's where the case will end. Are you the first? Ask your neighbor, are you brutal?
Are you brutal?
Ask your neighbor again, are you brutal?
Are you brutal?
Amen.
Amen.
I'm finishing it up here. Now, look at this one in the verse 4. It says, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God. Let me join you together so that I'm having a form of godliness but denying his power. Now, let me come from behind. Having a form of godliness, you show up in church all the time, but you know one thing, there is nothing in you that says God. Having a form of godliness, but the power is being denied. You don't have the attitude, you don't have nothing. Pleasure is all. Now, let me tell us what pleasure is. To lie down on your bed and watch your best program is what? Pleasure. Many brothers, many sisters cannot go extra mile with God. We have made God the God of easy journey. Oh my God. Now, I feel like talking about this. We have made God the God of pleasure. Right now, there is this message that if you have faith, nothing negative. If you are worshiping in the church and you have faith and something happens to you, leave that church. Because faith is supposed to protect you from anything. Who told you that thing? At the end of the day, we that have no
substance.
They have no value. Amen. Because their God is an easy one. God. Whenever situation is negative in their lives, everybody can just look at them in the face and know that this brother is suffering. The Bible said that the joy of the Lord is our strength. But some of us don't want to hear that message. It is the money in my pocket that is my strength. Whenever they have enough money, they are all smart. You shake the head and say, the Lord is good. Let something happen to them. You find out that God, he may be saying to God, the Lord is good. You just look at him, you know that God has loved him. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Because God, we have made God this washerman. God should be easy. Everything, if I am in God, it must be easy. The Bible said that that there is going to be trial for everybody who believes in God. It is that trial that proves whether you are genuine or whether you are just faking it. Amen.
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 Please, I want to call each and every one of us. This is the telling of time, the last days, that everybody needs to wake up and begin to ask himself, what am I doing for this God? Let me ask you a question. Some of you here, what are you doing for God? Amen. Some of you can sing, but you don't want to sing for God. You don't want the disturbance of showing up in church on Friday and showing up in church on Saturday. Hello? Some of you can teach, but come on, this preparatory. So pastor will not be coming here, we'll be seeing this pastor every time. Hello? Some of you can't even come to clean the church. Some don't know how anything is done. We just come on Sunday, we just sing. Pastor, that fan was not blowing very well last Sunday. Take note. Pastor, why were children entering inside the main church? Take note. Pastor, what about behind the church? I thought you said there was a time you would do something about it. Take note. Yes. Find something to do. Find something to do that you will say, this is the part I am playing for. Sister Precious, are you hearing me? The way you're looking at me this afternoon, that's how I tell your trouble. What do you say? I want us to be a